many components for our growth, that is vitamins, minerals, right, proteins. So even plants need those nutrients, like those nutrients for their growth. So this manures and fertilizers provide nutrients to the soil. Soil has its nutrients, but we need to add few nutrients more to the soil manually for their growth. Now, how are these manures and fertilizers prepared? Manures are the organic material. Those are prepared by the decomposition of plants and animal waste by microorganisms. As you have learned last year, that is vermicomposting. So, through vermicomposting, manures are produced. Manures are the organic substances that is produced. But vermicomposting and this decomposition of waste takes too much of time. So the production of manure is not that fast. Right? So, and the fertilizers. What are fertilizers? How are those prepared? Fertilizers we get chemically and it is produced in the factories. Fertilizers are the chemical based components. Right? For example, urea, ammonium sulfate, superphosphates, etc. These are the chemicals that are used as fertilizers in agriculture. Now, why do we need fertilizers? Right? These are the extra components that we add to the soil for proper growth. Right? We spray these fertilizers to the soil. It is necessary for few types of crops, but excessive use of fertilizers will disturb the soil fertility. It will disturb the plant growth. So nowadays the excessive use of fertilizers has started. It will even cause water pollution. How will this fertilizer cause water pollution? We are spraying it to the plants, to the soil, but we provide these plants with water also. Now extra water from the agriculture, from the field will flow out. So these fertilizers are water soluble, right? These fertilizers are water soluble. So they will be get soluble in the water and they will even flow along with the extra water. And it will cause water pollution also. So these fertilizers are necessary for the plant, for their growth, but to certain extent. There are ill effects of these fertilizers if they are used in excessive amount. And the manures, if we use manures for the providing, that is replenishment of nutrients to the soil, it is good. But we do not get manures in that much quantity that we need because it takes too much of time for their production. Right? Manures give soil a natural fertility. It will keep the soil in good texture also, right? By using fertilizers, soil fertility will be lost. But by using manures, soil fertility will be maintained. Its texture will be maintained. It also gives water a good water retaining capacity, right? So, through this point, you can get 2 to 3 questions to be taken care of. One is difference between manures and fertilizers. Number 2, advantages of using manures. Number 3, ill effects of using excessive fertilizers. From this point, you can get 3 questions to be learned. Right? So, this is, but there is one more method of replenishing the soil with nutrients. And that is through crop rotation. Now, what is crop rotation? Suppose there is a farmer who grows wheat every year, wheat crop every year, right? So, if he goes on cultivating wheat crops in the same field continuously, what will happen? Wheat plant required some type of nutrients, right? All plants do not require all nutrients. Every plant has its own speciality, right? So if he goes on cultivating only wheat plant in that field, that soil will be having the nutrients deficiency which a wheat plant require, because wheat plant will be consuming those nutrients continuously. Now what happens after 2 to 3 years? That soil is now in deficient of nutrients required by wheat plant. तो आगे क्या होगा? Wheat plant के nutrients तो सारे utilize हो गए. उसके बाद के जो crops आएंगे, that yield will be not good. इतना अच्छा नहीं होगा. Then what farmers will do? They will add manures and fertilizers. Now this will get soil fertility loosed off. ठीक है. Now another method what he can follow is he can rotate the plant. एक बार wheat plant grow किया, then next he can grow a pulse plant, leguminous plant. Now what are legumes? You have learned last year legumes, right? Those are the bacteria, rhizobiums that grow on the roots of few plants. They fix the atmosphere nitrogen to the soil. तो अगर एक बार उसने wheat plant grow किया, next time if it grows a leguminous plant, then that soil will get ammonia. Legumes will fix that atmosphere ammonia in the soil, right? So by rotating the crops, the soil will get its nutrients naturally composed in it itself. So that soil will not require much manures and fertilizers to be added. जो भी फील्ड में रोटेशन होता है प्लांट्स का, वहां पे मैन्यूर्स और फर्टिलाइजर्स का यूज कम करना पड़ता है. एंड दैट इज अ वेरी गुड पॉइंट. इट इज दैट प्लांट्स विल गेट नेचुरल न्यूट्रिएंट्स. सो वी कैन रिप्लेनिश आवर सॉइल विद दिस मेथड आल्सो, दैट इज क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन, रोटेटिंग क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन एंड यूजिंग द क्रॉप्स अल्टरनेटिवली.